Well, you know, this is my third Corvette. First one I had was Indianapolis 500. I was the pace car driver, and I fell in love with the Corvette I used then. So I went and bought one. And then in 2013, I thought, hey, this one's 8 years old, I'll get another one. So I bought a 2013, but they were already coming out with the new styles then, and I was lusting after the
next C7,
model.
Yeah.
Yeah. And so my kids knew that I was really interested in the new one. So for Christmas last year, unbeknownst to me, I'm going to my son's house, and there, sitting there in the garage, is a brand new 2015. With a Christmas bow on top of it, the whole family. It's a present from the kids. I said, that is so cool. You know, I love you kids so much, and I'm so glad you love me. Couldn't believe it. I couldn't believe it.
Please welcome Michael Powell, son of General Colin Powell and Vice President of America's Promise Alliance, to the stage. Please give him a BARRETT-JACKSON welcome.
Thank you. Thank you, Craig and Steve, and from the Powell family, we are grateful to be here from the bottom of our heart. My father would love this event and he would love this crowd. My dad was an American soldier. He loved America and he credited the Army for making something of a kid from the Bronx who started with so little. My dad believed that every child deserved the same opportunity that he had. So when he put his stars away, he founded America's Promise Alliance to light the way for a new generation. My dad relished this Corvette as a symbol of his American dream come true. He drove it every single day. He'd be thrilled to see us auctioning his pride and joy for the charity he cherished to help the kids that he so loved. This auction honors the legacy of Colin Powell, and God willing, will help us raise up the next great American hero. Thank you.
There you go. Thank you for being at BARRETT-JACKSON. Joseph, let's raise some money in his honor.
General Colin Powell, Chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, U.S. Secretary of State. This, in retirement, was his daily driver. What a car, what a story, and all for charity, a great cause.
We saw some ZR1s cross the block earlier with the peekaboo supercharged LS9 under the hood. This one is the basic package with a 6.2 liter, but still 400 plus horsepower. Automatic transmission.
Especially in these times. We need more Colin Powells.
75. I had to get down 175. Hey, you got 150 down there.
And this is the first year for the C7 Corvette. We see the Stingray motif on the front fender, and that was a nice throwback. It had been a long time since Chevrolet utilized the Stingray name in coordination with the Corvette, and we see it here again.
$200,000 from General Colin Powell's 2015 Corvette Stingray, every penny will go to benefit America's Promise Alliance, as they mentioned, hopefully finding that next Colin Powell out there, helping disadvantaged youth.
How does this help the cause that he set up, I believe?
It helps enormously. This organization was founded by all the living presidents in the early 90s who believed that the country owed every child a greater promise of opportunity. And so it started out as a volunteer weekend, and he decided this can't be a one-off. We have to turn it into something real. We founded America's Promise, and we've been fighting for the rights of kids ever since to have the kind of opportunity that allowed him to become a great American hero.
And I imagine with $200,000, you'll be able to do a bit.
Oh, they're going to be very excited tonight.
And what practically does that do?
It does an enormous amount. We're in the process of building an alliance for the next generation of challenges for children. Children really suffered during COVID and the pandemic. A lot of them fell behind in education. There's a need to really surge resources for that. So a lot of it will go towards those efforts on the ground.
Well, it is all due to the generosity of these folks here.
Our pleasure.
Why is this so important to you?
Oh my goodness. I mean, this is our first trip to BARRETT-JACKSON. Such a dream come true. We've been watching it on TV for years. huge car lovers of Colin Powell fans. You know, bless his heart. This is very special for us, my husband Greg and I. So we feel extremely blessed to be a part of this.
Your name's Greg?
Greg, yes. So General Powell has done so much for our country, and I've over the years, when we saw it was his car and it was going to his charity, we had to buy the car.
And Craig, veteran causes, you...
This was a great one. When we were on the phone, just seeing the eulogy that Michael did for his father, oh my God. Wasn't a dry eye in the nation. Thank you for everything.
What I love about this is your father drove this every day. There is a story, though, that he went to lunch in Washington that maybe didn't go the way it was planned.
This is a classic Washington, D.C. story. He drove to an event at a particular embassy, whose name I will leave out, and when he came out, the car wouldn't start, and he recognized immediately why, and he walked back in the embassy and ordered them to stop jamming the circuitry so that a car wouldn't start, which is something they would do. So they kind of chagrined and turned off the jammer and let him get in his car and go home.
Well, Don and Holly, I should say, and Craig, I'm not going to forget that one. You're not going to have that trouble at all.
I hope they got that fixed. No.
We'll take you back after the block.